Good morning. I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Tuesday, March 28th. It is going to be cloudy today, and there's the possibility we're going to see some sprinkles. Our chief meteorologist, Dan Zarrow, says it's really going to be an unsettled weather pattern through the rest of this week. Temperatures will flip-flop between cool and warm, really through the rest of the month, and still the possibility of a rain chance for a couple of more days this week. Dan's full forecast is available on air online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. New Jersey American Water customers are being urged to voluntarily conserve water, even as tests come back negative for contamination after that big chemical spill in Pennsylvania. State and federal officials are monitoring the water system after the spill into a Pennsylvania creek that feeds the Delaware below Trenton. Trenton City officials are also monitoring the Trenton Water Works. No samples taken have shown any contaminants into any New Jersey water system so far. Seven additional Mercer County residents that are served by the Trenton Water Works have tested positive for Legionnaires' disease, and two of them have died. State health officials revealing the grim news on Monday. The Murphy administration said last year they had significant concerns about operations at Trenton Water Works after test samples showed the presence of Legionella bacteria. The best ways to avoid contamination, I write more about that this morning at nj1015.com. A growing number of New Jersey residents are falling victim to mail fraud in New Jersey. Congressman Josh Gottheimer is demanding the U.S. Post Office take immediate steps to stop the recent surge in change of address fraud. That's where criminals can redirect all of your mail to a new location without your knowledge or consent. The information in that mail is then used for identity fraud. Motor vehicle officials announcing a big change in New Jersey with how you produce your registration. You'll be able to do it electronically now instead of with a paper one. Honoring a bill that was signed into law by Governor Murphy in 2021, you can flash an electronic version of your vehicle registration to police when you're pulled over instead of digging through the glove box for the paper version. An emailed PDF of your registration will be sent when you complete an online renewal or a duplicate registration transaction with the state. Gas prices held steady again overnight. AAA putting the statewide average this morning at $3.21 a gallon for regular. That's quite a bit less than the national average of $3.43, though prices nationally have declined. In New Jersey, they've held around that $3.20 a gallon mark for about a month, but last year we were paying a dollar more per gallon. Sea Isle City is the latest New Jersey town to consider a strict curfew in an attempt to curb rowdy teenage behavior this summer. City Council will vote today on the ordinance banning anybody under the age of 18 to be on any public street between the hours of 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. Businesses would also be banned from allowing juveniles on their premises. There are exceptions, kids with their parents or guardians coming back from a job or participating in a recreation program. Bed Bath & Beyond has notified the Department of Labor they are planning another round of layoffs in New Jersey. 1,300 positions will be eliminated at the corporate offices in Union, as well as warehouses and fulfillment centers in New Jersey. The company's already announced the closure of 150 stores, including a handful in the Garden State. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video, and remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Tuesday, March 28th. Have a great day.